Let us remember the life of an amazing woman, Maria. So, I'm here today to talk about her, especially her and only her. So, me as her guardian angel, I have a lot of things to talk about her. Especially that she died so young. I'm not even dead yet, and I'm like a million years old. So, let's see. I have plenty of stories about her. So there's one story that we were having dinner once. It was like, 10 p.m. And all of a sudden, it's silence. Well, guess what? When it's silence, you don't want to hear her because she has so much things unpredictable that comes out of her mouth, Maria's mouth. So we were all eating and then there's a silence and then she speaks. She's like, why don't we play a game? Well, how do you play a game if there's so many people of different ages? There's like old people, really old people, and there's young, and there's like children and everything. So all of a sudden she's like, oh, let's play hide and seek. The older ones, no offense, count because you guys can't run. And the younger ones, well, they could play, they could run, they could hide, and then the older ones will just probably just find them. So that was an amazing night with her family, my family. It was just spectacular. Who would know that was the last night you would play with someone, or that was the last day you would see someone alive and then all of a sudden dead? So then there's like other stories. I don't want to get too sad about her death. It's kind of sad. She died when she was asleep. It's something that I would recommend if, well, you're dying. I'm an angel, so I'd probably see your soul up and ask you and everything. So I asked her, how did it feel? She's like, oh, it's nothing. I'm okay. So yeah, it's normal. It didn't hurt or anything. So I was like, okay, that's fine. Good. I'll see you soon. See you later. I have to talk about you and your funeral. Kind of weird. She's like, okay, just don't talk anything weird. Although I'm weird, she said. I was like, okay, that's fine. So her main goal in life, let's see what else. Her main goal in life was to be a teacher. Well, she was a teacher in Mars, teaching aliens how to speak Spanish. And aliens don't even have their own language. They have, like, I don't know what it's called. It's just alien language. So then she wanted to teach. And then after she was done teaching that alien, she wanted to teach in a university for aliens. I didn't know aliens could go to university, but yeah. So she wanted also to conquer outer space, which is kind of like, yeah, that's kind of interesting. You should do that, maybe. Or if you want to, I'm not sure. So that's one of the good things about her. She was a very spectacular woman. She was so special to a lot of us. She would be very missed and loved by her friends and family, especially her kids and her husband that acts like a 2-year-old. Sorry about that. She told me to say that. And, well, there's another story. She did a crazy thing once that she didn't want me to tell anyone about it, but I had to because it's so funny. I just thought so hard. So once she did, she told me she wanted to dye her hair. She wanted to dye her hair at home by herself. So you would imagine she wanted to dye it blonde. So you would imagine black to blonde. It's like something crazier. You don't expect it to go from black to yellow. Even though there's a song about that. You should hear it. So she dyed her hair from black to yellow. So in 3 hours, you imagine it didn't turn out yellow. It turned out orange. She practically just shaved her head. That's all she wanted. She just laughed at the mirror and she was like crying. She's like, oh, I'm not going to have this orange hair. She shaved it. And, well, there's so many funny things that she's going to be very missed. And everything's going to be so hard on us for not to have her here. Even though she was very old. Well, not that old, but okay. She was kind of old. And I hate talking about sad things, so let's just skip to the good part. Let's talk about her childhood. She had a very good childhood. She grew up with a lot of mammals. A lot of them. I don't know. She's kind of weird about that. She had an 8 for a mom. And her dad was a lion. So that's kind of weird. Yeah. And she had a couple tigers at her brothers and sisters. Yeah. Good thing I wasn't related to her. So, well, and her children were bear cubs. So that's kind of weird. But at the same time, it's very interesting because you have different types of animals in your family. And last but not least, let's have a moment of silence for her and her full death, even though she was so young. And I can't believe she's dead. Well, I could, because she was just... I just wanted her to have be next to me forever and ever, even though I'll take care of her always, but you never know. She might just want to go somewhere else. And, well, all I can say is thank you, and that everything I've done is and talked about her was just so special, and I can't believe I actually talked a lot about her today. Thank you.